In a game that's a preview of the 2018 season opener, the Raiders and the Rams met in Los Angeles for the Silver and Black's second preseason game this season. Hello, I'm Brian Salmon. This is Vegas Nation. Now, tons of storylines in this one, folks, even if it was just a preseason game. The Raiders' first game inside of LA Colliseum since 1994, and no matter, Raider Nation was still in full force in LA. Their planes flying overhead with signs saying, "This is Raiders country," tailgating. Fans actually booing the Rams inside their own stadium. The head coaches, John Gruden, well, he gave Rams head coach Sean McVay his first job in the NFL, so the roots run deep between these two teams. But to the game, Raiders come out looking horrible on offense. Connor Cook opened up the game with multiple three and outs, chased that with a fumble that he lost. Overall, Cook was 6-for-12 for 49 yards. He was also sacked once. Both teams, well, they showed nada on offense because, of course, they're playing in week one. But somehow, the Raiders managed to trail 16-0 in the third quarter before finally actually deciding to play this game. Oakland, they score 15 straight points. Chris Warren, a 3-yard touchdown, brings it to 16-6. E.J. Manuel throws a 10-yard touchdown pass to Griff Whalen, closing the gap to 16-15. And that's when Coach Gruden decides to go for two instead of tying the game with an extra point. But, folks, there's always a but. In the end, the Rams would beat the Raiders in this game 19-15. All right, now it's time to bring in our guys who were in the Coliseum for this barn burner of a game, this instant classic. Not really. Raiders beat writer Michael Gelkin and NFL writer Gilberto Manzano. I'll start with Michael. I guess, what, if anything, did the Raiders get out of this game, considering they really didn't play any of their starters, plus exercised extreme vanilla offense?
Right, the Raiders are getting out of this game what they wanted to get out of it. You looked at the offense. 15 guys from the offense did not play this game. Derek Carr and plenty of company. And then on defense, 6 guys they rested for non-medical reasons, just because these two teams are facing each other twice in a 24-day span, with a big one, September 10 season opener, coming up. So for Gruden, he said this is all about evaluating the depth of this roster, really taking a look at not the ones, but the twos, the threes, the guys who are fighting to make this roster on special teams. And so they're going to get a lot of quality film. You know, it's a short flight back to Oakland, so I'm sure when they get to their team facility in Alameda, they'll get a real chance to dig into it. But they want to figure out what the back end of this roster looks like when they need to cut down from 90 to 53 players on September 1st.
All right, cool. Thank you very much, Michael. Now, Gilbert, you documented it very well on social media. How much of a home field was it for the Raiders? How loud and visible was Raider Nation out there in L.A.?
Oh, very loud. It felt like a Raiders home game. It was the first time back at the L.A. Memorial Coliseum since they left the city, I think in 1994, about 24 years. There's a lot of L.A. fans, Southern California fans, that were happy to see the Raiders one more time in their backyard. So I walked around, I think it was parking lot 6. It was covered in silver and black. I hardly saw any blue and gold. So Raider fans were excited. It was a party there. Everybody had a good time. I didn't see any fights or anything like that. So it was a good atmosphere. And for the Raiders, you know, fans to have their team back for one night, it was a preseason game for one day. They felt good. A lot of memories came back for these fans.
No fights for a Raider game? What the heck is going on?
No fight. It's preseason. You got to relax.
Okay, I got you. Michael, the Raiders really didn't play any of the players, as you noted, Derek Carr, Marshawn Lynch, Amari Cooper, all those guys. But Chris Warren, he absolutely played. 18 carries for 110 yards. He looked very good thus far in the preseason. How many running backs really are they going to keep, and whose job is Warren getting ready to take?
Yeah, I think it's worth running through. So you look at 2 running backs did not play today for the Raiders, Marshawn Lynch and Doug Martin. Neither did fullback Keith Smith. Let's just consider him a running back as well for our purposes. So that's 3 running backs that are going to be on this roster. Jalen Richard, as a guy who's very versatile at the backfield as a receiver, he's expected to make it. That brings us to 4. Tough to imagine them keeping more than 5. I think we're talking about 5 running backs. You're probably looking at, is it DeAndre Washington? Or is it Chris Warren? And we saw DeAndre Washington have 0 carries here on Saturday. As you mentioned, Chris Warren, very busy, the 18 carries, 110 yards, and the score. I got to think, based on what the Raiders have seen from Chris Warren, who now, by the way, has about 200 rushing yards in these 2 exhibitions, it's going to be pretty hard to waive him.
Now, Gilbert, I know you're working on a story on Reggie McKenzie, the fact that he played with the Raiders in L.A. And they hadn't played there since 1994. I guess if you can give us a little sneak peek, if I can twist your arm, give me a sneak peek of what you're writing about.
Yeah, the Raiders general manager Reggie McKenzie was in the press box, so he got to watch Chris Warren, you know, up close. So I talked to him at halftime about, you know, coming back to the LA Coliseum and how it felt for him, because he was a rookie when he played here. I think he was a starting linebacker for the Raiders in 1985. He still remembers his first game playing with the Raiders at the Coliseum. It was a 31-0 victory against the Jets, and he was still very excited about that win, you know, so long ago. But for Reggie, he said the Coliseum is still pretty much the same besides the track that was around. He said it's still a very gigantic stadium, the Olympic style, the atmosphere, the aura is still there. For Reggie, he was happy to see LA fans still rooting, and he's very optimistic that Oakland fans will do the same in Las Vegas.
Wow, Gilbert, we're going to have to get Reggie McKenzie to talk to all the people on social media that send emails via the mailbag about how Raider fans are going to stick with him when they come to Vegas, right?
Yeah, definitely. You know, Reggie told me that he didn't get that sense at all a year ago. He said that the Oakland fans were still very passionate about the team. He felt that the fandom is still very high, and he was very positive about the move and, you know, keeping, you know, Raider Nation alive in Las Vegas.
Lastly, Michael, how disappointed was Gruden in some of the performance of his team, the fact that they got multiple penalties and they really started off the game very poorly on offense, 3 and out.
You're right. There was ball security issues. Two both E.J. Manuel and Connor Cook were rotating in this game. Both were credited with a lost fumble. You had unnecessary roughness penalties, multiple of those. And the first half offense was just atrocious. You yeah. saw Raiders managed 58 yards of offense. They had two turnovers. They had one first down. They didn't put up a point on the scoreboard, and they allowed three sacks. It was just abysmal. Gruden called it embarrassing. It was not what they wanted to put on film. This wasn't the offensive start that the Raiders had in mind. They did finish things in the second half, but again, this is for the Raiders. All the guys they arrested, this is all about September 10th.
With that being said, did E.J. Manuel close the gap at all with Connor Cook, or do you kind of get the sense that that job, for the most part, the backup quarterback is pretty much done?
I would say, I can tell you the coaching staff is going to want to look at the film before they really measure the two up. And so for me to say, without having the luxury of film and what those coaches are looking at, it'd be hard for me to say whether or not that needle moves or how it moves today. But I do think E.J. Manuel probably showed a little more consistency over the course of the game. You saw him get into a rhythm there. But I don't know in terms of whether or not it truly impacted that standing in terms of number two, number three quarterback. Thus far, we've seen Cook get the early edge in reps. He was a quarterback we saw first here on Saturday.
Gotcha, Michael. Appreciate it. Now, big thanks to both of our guys, Raiders beat writer Michael Gelkin, of course, and NFL writer Gilberto Manzano, for joining us here on Vegas Nation from the City of Angels. Now, once again, the Raiders fall to the LA Rams. The final score in this one was 19-15. And, of course, you can read all of their work at reviewjournal.com. You can also check out all of our Raiders videos and podcasts on our Vegas Nation app. Also, Roku Television and Amazon Fire Stick also has our videos. So for Michael Gelkin and for Gilberto Manzano, I'm Brian Talbot for Vegas Nation, folks. We'll see you next time.